So hello everyone. Actually, I wasn't making videos because I was waiting for a mic because lots of people told me that the video is not audible properly. That's why I was waiting for mic. So today's video is not about CETAs or TOC or DAA. It's about how to prepare for GATE, because some people asked me because how means like which subject to do, then after doing the subject what to do, what's the procedure. So I'll be making that steps in this video only. So the like how the process. So the way I prepared, I will prefer you to do. So make your own timetable or something, own procedures. But the steps I will tell you to follow. Number one, complete the subject. Let's see here that the subjects, the way number the subjects you are following, like I followed C, DS, then DAA, then TOC. So you can do it any order, because it's not like you have to do it TOC first and DS first. It's not like that. If you are in college and C will be your in first or second semester, so do them that way only, because it will be helpful in your college semester preparation also and GATE. So that is the way I will tell you. But if you are pass out and you are working or you are a full-time GATE aspirant, then you have the leverage. You can do any subject at a time, like two subjects at a time. You are doing parallelly half in morning, you are doing one subject, in evening you are doing another subject. So that is up to you. Because if you are preparing self-study or if you have taken any coaching online or offline, whatever, or you are following YouTube videos or my videos. I'm not suggesting my videos because I haven't done other subjects yet. I will do, but I have started with CDS because I preferred it doing first. So this is up to you which way you are doing. So now I'll tell you what to do and the procedure. So now the first thing first is complete the subject. Let's say here I'm taking C and DS. So what should you do? Like if you are self-studying, then you should have some notes or videos, like YouTube videos, NPTEL videos. There are lots of videos you can see, or books. There are lots of books also, so you can prefer. But I won't suggest reading the whole book. Like there are this big book, books are like this big, so you cannot study the whole book. It will take time and it's not very efficient also. So you have to study properly the things you need. So like once you are completed with the subjects, let's say you are completed the subjects you have done. Next procedure is very important, is solve PYQs, means previous year's questions. See, in GATE questions won't be repeated, but the concepts will be repeated, and at least you will get the concept what kind of questions the in GATE they are asking. And how should you approach the questions? Because learning a subject is like a basic thing. But once you are done with the subject, you should know how to solve. So solving, there are various online, but I prefer offline reading books. So I already told you can buy from Amazon. You don't have to go somewhere, but buy from Amazon a book. Or you can search online. There are solved examples are there. So I suggest solve the PYQs. So if you are unable to solve, then go back and study the subject again. But while solving, you can see Geeks for Geeks, GATE Overflow. These two are life savior, because I have done from Made Easy book, but then also I had some questions how to solve and all. But these two will be a life savior, because here you will get solution, and in Geeks for Geeks you will get very good solution. In Made Easy book also it's very good solution, but still GO gate overflow is like they will be have discussions, people will suggest different way, and there will be a best answer among them. You can see that answer or see others also. So this is the second step. Third is do workbook. This is completely optional because I won't I'm not sure you will get enough time to do after PYQs of workbook also, because PYQs, like 30 years of PYQs are there, at least 25 years to 30 years they are available. So after doing this, I don't know how much time will be left with this, because you have to do all the other subjects also. So this is optional. So there will be workbook, different workbook materials will be available. So I don't know about this. I don't know, because if I suggest you to do this, and you may not come able to complete all the subjects also. So number four, very important, test series. I'll make a separate video on test series. So test series is like very important. It will play the key role to your preparation as well as your rank. So test series, how to solve test series. There will be first topic test. In every test series, there will be topic test. Then there will be subject test. So first do the topic tests and then do the subject test. So test series which to take, which not to take, I'll do another video. But here I'm just suggesting you to do the topic test first. Like in CDS, there will be first, there will be like recursion or something. I don't remember, but topic test you do first. Then, because see, the first time you are doing, you won't be getting good marks, so that is like demotivating for me, or it was also. But don't get disheartened by that, because subject you have to learn, subject test you have to learn, not score. Because after getting the knowledge of each subject, then you will be able to get good marks only. So for topic test and subject test, even if you are getting very low marks, that is not very important, because you are learning, you are in process of learning the subject now. So in later, when it's December and next year January, so then you can see what your marks in your mock tests and all. But now focus on learning. So this is the procedure for at least one subject, C and DS. So I'm just telling, like for example, you can do TOC also or CN, anything. So for first, complete the subject, then solve PYQs, workbook optional, completely up to you. Then test series. Test series is very important. These two are very important. Once you have completed with the subject, do this at least, because it's very important. So now, after completing a single subject, so let's say you are completed with D, C, D, S, all the procedure, all the steps. So now you should go on to next subjects. Let's say DAA. Complete that also, but it's very important, you should revise again CDS in some time, in your particular timetable. You should give some particular time so that you can go back and revise the subjects. So don't do like this, that say you have completed CDS and again in December you have started. So it will be a complete new subject for you, because in a span of 6-7 months you will completely forget, because there are other subjects which are very big, OAS, CA. So do a cyclic revision, like circular queue kind of thing I'll do. So you will do a circular revision you should do. Let's say you have prepared CDS and then you are preparing DAA, then you have prepared TOC. But in between these two subjects, give some time for CDS also, because you should keep on remembering the things. Not remember, I mean like remember by heart, but at least you should be able to do some problems whenever you are asked. So not very confident, but at least you should be able to recall that where I have studied this, when, in which notes or everything. You should be able to do that, because if you are planning to revise everything after doing all the subjects, that will be a blunder, because you will forget half the things you have prepared. So this is all about today's video. Because I was asked, I told some that I will make a separate video on how to prepare for GATE, and test series I will make a separate video. So now, this is